So good morning, students. Today I will explain your topic number 3. It's the expansion. Okay, so now I'm going to start your topic, expansion. But before the expansion, I want to ask something right now. Can you tell me, actually your topic is expansion, where we will expand something. So now, before the starting of the topic, I want to ask this thing, what 2 to the power 2 is what? You will tell me what, it's a 4. But how this 4 has been came? It's by 2 into 2. Is it clear? Now, next is, suppose, 3 to the power 2 I am asking to you. So this will give you what? 3 into 3 into, so 3 to the power 2 is what? 3 into 3, this is 9. Is it clear? Next, suppose here is 4 to the power 3. This will give you what? 4 into 4 into 4. Means if here the power is 3, that means we will multiply 4 how many times? 3 times, 1, 2, and 3. So this will give you here 3 is what? This 3 is what? Number of powers. These are powers. It's a 3. 4 4 is 16, 16 4 is 64. Okay. So now will you tell me here? Actually, I have to tell you product of two binomial. How will you? Here, product of two binomial. I have to explain it. How will you product the two binomials? Binomials. Product means multiply. Two binomials. So first thing is your mind, what is binomial? At first I will explain binomial. What is binomial? Binomial is what? An algebraic expression. An algebraic expression having two terms is called binomial. Is called binomial. An algebraic expression having two terms is called binomial. See the example. I'm writing here the x plus y. Okay. Or x minus y. Is it clear? So can you tell me how many terms are here? It's so x and y. Here a first term and it is second. Similarly, first and second. Okay, so binomials is what? An algebraic expression having two terms is called binomial. Now, so product of two binomials. So we have to see, we have to multiply here the two binomials. I have to take here the binomials. Let if I am writing here x plus a, is it clear? And suppose here is x plus a and a into x plus b. Okay. So what is the meaning of this statement? The product here are two binomials. Okay, it's not a binomial, it's a two binomials. Okay, so first binomial and it is second binomial, and both the binomials having two terms. Because of this, these are called the binomial. So x plus a and x plus b, if there is no sign between two digits, that means it will be product, multiply. So what we have now, x plus a into x plus b, this will give you what? C. X will be multiplied by all the terms of the second binomial. So x, at first we will multiply this x, the x multiply by x, this will give you what? X square. You can, in starting I will write here x into x. Okay, now this will, x has been over. Now second, it's a plus. Here is which sign? Plus. So we will apply here the plus, and x will be multiplied by b. This will give you x into b. X, the multiplication of x has been finished. Now I will discuss about the plus a. Now plus a is also multiplied by second term, second binomial. So a will be multiplied by x. What is the sign here? This is also plus. If you have any variable, okay, and before it there is no any sign, here is no any sign, so you will say here is what? Plus sign. So plus a multiplied by x, this will give you a into x, and plus a multiplied by b, this will give you what? A into b. So what we have, x into x, this is x square plus bx plus a into x, ax, and plus ab. So it's x square plus. What is common here? X is common. So we will write here the b plus a and plus ab. In this way, you will multiply. Okay, do the homework here. X plus a, it's not homework. Right now, I will explain it. Okay, so write down it. Now next, if I am writing here the a plus b to the whole square, a plus b to the whole square, is it clear? So 2 to the power 2, you can write a 2 into 2. Similarly, a plus b, here the a plus b, how will you write 2? 2 times you will write it. So it will be a plus b. And what is the sign between? 2 to the whole square, this means 2 into 2. So a plus b to the whole square, this will give you a plus b into a plus b. Okay. So now, one by one, same as we will multiply here, this will give you a into a square plus a into b. A into b is what? Ab. The multiplication of a has been over. Now start with the b. B multiplied by a. This is what? Plus. What is the sign here? Plus sign is here. So it will be BA. And plus B multiplied by B, this will give you B square. So this is what? A square plus AB. And listen, it's a BA. Can you tell me 2 into 3 is what? 6. And 3 into 2 is also 6. So that means both are same. So we can write it AB. And plus B square. So it's a square plus ab plus ab, 2ab, and plus b square. Similarly, see next, a minus b to the whole square. These are the algebraic identities, okay? So it is also, you have to memorize. So now, means a plus b to the whole square is what? It's a formula. A square plus b square plus 2ab. Similarly, a minus b to the whole square is what? You will write again 2 times a minus b into a minus b. Okay. So again, a multiplied by a, this will give you a square. And a multiplied by minus b, this will give you what? Minus. Because a is multiplying here the minus b. So minus a into b, that means ab. And now minus b multiplied by plus a. So minus b multiplied by minus b multiplied by plus a. So this will give you what? At first, we will multiply minus sign with plus. Hello.
One thing very interesting here. Negative things, if multiply with the positive things, that then will be negative. Okay. If negative multiply by positive, if you have a negative values, okay, and positive value, then you will multiply. Because of this, every time your parents told to you, don't ignore him because he is bad boy. Okay, if you will play with the bad boy, you will also be a bad boy. Okay, so because of this, it's a perfect example. So if minus will multiply by the positive, then you will get a negative value. But of course, yeah, if negative will be multiplied by the negative, that means it will be positive. Okay,
so a square minus ab and minus b multiply by plus a, so this will also give you minus b, and minus b multiply by minus b, minus b multiply by minus b, it is plus b square. Clear? So now what we have, a square minus ab and it is minus b, so we can write it minus ab and plus b square. This will give you a square minus ab minus ab, this is minus 2ab and plus b square. Okay, now ready for the next. A minus b and a plus b is what? A minus b and a plus b is what? See here, a, we will multiply a with a plus b, so a multiply by a, this is a square, and plus a multiply by b, this is plus ab. Is that clear? Now times of b, it's a minus b, so minus b multiply by a, this will give you minus ba, and minus b multiply by plus b, so minus multiply by plus, negative multiply by positive, it will give you negative, so minus b square. So this means it is a square plus ab, we can write it minus ab and minus b square. So this is plus ab and here is minus ab, it will be cancel out. What we have, a square minus b square, this is a formula. A minus b, a plus b is what? A square minus b square. Ready for the next? Will you tell me a plus b to the power 3, how many times you will multiply a plus b? 3 times. A plus b into a plus b into a plus b. Then how will you solve it? A multiply by, it's, we know it's a, a plus b into a plus b, it is what? A plus b to the whole square and into a plus b. So this will give you, now open it, a plus b to the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus 2ab into a plus b. Okay, so you can also write a plus b multiplied by a square plus b square plus 2ab. 1 by 1 you will multiply. At first we will multiply what? We will multiply a with all these terms. So a multiply by a, this will give you a cube. A multiply by b square, this will give you ab square, and now a multiply by 2ab, this will give you what? 2a square b. The multiplication of a has been finished. Now ready for the b. B will multiply by b. Don't make these signs on your notebook, on your copy. Okay, you can directly multiply. So plus b multiply by a square, this will give you plus b a square, and now plus b multiply by b square, this will give you plus b cube. And plus b multiply by 2ab, so this is what? 2ab square. So what we have, at first we will write the powers, the where the degree is 3, the highest power, highest powers are a cube, then b cube, and the sign is plus a. And after that it's a 2a square b and it is a a square b, so this is 2a square b plus a square b, it is what? You can write it 2a square b plus a square b plus 2ab square plus ab square, so it is what? A cube plus b cube, 2a square b plus a square b, this is 3a square b, and plus 2ab square plus ab square, it's a 3ab square. So this is the value of, this is the formula for the algebraic identities. It's a cube plus b cube plus 3. Listen, here is what common, you can write it as a formula for the a plus b to the power 3. If anyone asks to you what is the formula for the a plus b to the power 3, you can directly speak a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. But if you want to take there the common 3ab, then you can more simplify the expression. It's a 3ab is common, so this will give you a plus b. Okay, that's it. Now in this way you are I teach you how will you multiply with the polynomials and also the trinomials. Trinomials is what is the trinomial, monomials, polynomials or binomials? Trinomials means what? An algebraic expression having three terms. This is called a trinomial. Polynomial means an algebraic expression having two terms is called a binomial. And monomial, it is what? An algebraic expression having only single term, like a x. So this is what? It's a monomial. Ready for the next? I'm going to explain here directly. You should learn this formula. A plus b plus c to the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. If you want to multiply, you can prove it by multiply of a plus b plus c. Actually here are how many terms? The power is 2, so we will multiply it and terms will be 2 a plus b plus c by this. You can get, this is your perfect formula. You should learn it. Okay, any issue? So now I'm going to start your exercise, but before I want to tell you something more. For the perfect square, if when you will speak something is perfect square, for perfect square, see here, if a plus b to the whole square is equal a square plus b square plus 2ab, okay, if a plus b to the whole square is equal a square plus b square plus 2ab, then it is known as perfect square. I will explain it when I will attempt your questions. So I'm going to start your exercise. Okay, and here I'm going to show some formulas. This formula for the cube of binomials, the formula for the a plus b plus a plus b to the power 3, and here is the formula a minus b to the power 3. These are, you should learn these formulas. Okay, but if your concept is clear, there is no need to learn. Okay, you can multiply it, but it will take some time. So if you will memorize it, it will be better for the question, for you also. So now I'm going to start your exercise 3. The first question is, write down the product for each of the following. So first question I have taken here, the first part of the first question. We have to write down the product for each of the following. This is what we have to write down, the product x plus 4 and x plus 2. How will you multiply it? X plus 4 and x plus 2. How will you multiply it? X will be multiplied by, at first we will multiply x by x plus 2. So x will be, this x will be multiplied. So it's give you x square plus x will be multiplied by 2. This will give you plus, it's plus 2. So it is what? 2x. And now ready for the 4. 4 will be multiply here the x plus 2. So 4 multiply by x, it is what? 4x. And plus 4 multiply by 2, this is what? 4 to the 8. And now see here, the x square plus 2x plus 4x. 2x plus 4x is what? 6x plus 8. This is the product of the first question. Now see the second question. Write down the square of the following expression. We have to find out the square of the following expression. Just like a square of question is question number second, part first. Square of expression 3x plus 5y. What is the square of the expression 3x plus 5y? That means they are asking to you what is the 3x plus 5y to the whole square is what? So again I am going to explain here. You will multiply 3x plus 5 by how many times? 2 times. It is what? 3x plus 5y into 3x plus 5y. So at first we will multiply 3x by all the all these terms. 3x multiply by 3x is it what? 3x multiply by 3x. So listen,
constant number will be multiplied by the constant number at first. So 3 multiply by 3, this will give you what? 9.
And x will be multiplied by x, it is what? X square. Okay, so 3x multiply by 3x, this is what? 9x square. Is that clear? Now 3x multiply by 5 by, so 3 multiply at first by 5, this is what? Plus 15. And x multiply by y, this is what? X will you multiply by, this will give you x by. So x by, and now it's a time for the 5 by. If you multiply 5 by, this will give you what? 5 by multiply by 3x, it is also 15 x by. Okay, because 5 3 is 15, and by into x, it is by x or x by, both are same. And now 5 by multiply by 5 by plus 5 by, so 5 5 is 25, and it is by square. So answer is 9 x square plus 15 x by plus 15xy, this is what? 30xy plus 25y square. In this way you can solve it. If you want to write, you can. Now ready for the third question. Third is what? Simplify, third question, simplify 2x minus p plus c to the whole square and minus 2x plus p minus c to the whole square. 2x minus p plus c to the whole square and minus 2x plus p minus c to the whole square. Now we will solve it. See here. Solution, see the simplification solution is, we have what? We have a 2x minus p plus c to the whole square and minus 2x plus p minus c to the whole square. So see how many terms are here, 1 2 and 3. You have any formula where you have two terms? Of course, a plus b plus c to the whole square, we will use this formula. We know that a plus b plus c to the whole square is what? A square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. It's a lengthy question. Is it clear? So apply this formula here. At first we will take this term. Okay, what is the term? So 2x minus p plus c to the whole square is what? Will you tell me here, what is the value of a? A is 2x. What is the value of b? B is minus p. And what is the value of c? C is already positive c. So at the place of a, we will put 2x. So this is what? 2x to the whole square. Okay, now plus b, what is the value of b? B is minus p. B is c here. What is the value of b? B is minus p. Minus p to the whole square plus c. C is already c, it's a c square, plus 2 into a for 2x into b for minus p. You will multiply here the sign. You will write here the value of my b minus p. And now 2bc, it's a time for the 2bc, plus 2 into b, b for again minus p. And what is the value of c? C is already c. And now plus 2c, c for c and a for 2x. So this will give you what? 2x to the whole square is what? 4x square. Minus p to the whole square, minus p, see here, minus p to the whole square is what? Minus p multiply by minus p. So listen, minus multiply by minus, this will give you my negative, will be multiply by negative, it will positive. And p multiply by p, this will give you what? P square. So because of this, it is plus p square plus c square. One by one, see my finger and also marker. C square. 2, 2 ja 4. Okay, plus 4. And now x multiply by minus p. So this is what? Minus xp. So because of this, listen, minus xp I am writing here. And now plus, plus 2 minus p multiply by c. This is what? Minus pc. Minus pc. And plus 2 to the 4 and c multiply by x, this is 4cx. Any issue? Now simplify more. This will give you what? 4x square plus p square plus c square and plus 4 plus multiply by negative. This will be, sign will be interchanged, it will be negative. Plus multiply by minus. Here I told you, if here is plus sign and here is minus sign, so the between plus and minus there is no sign. Between plus, plus and minus there is no sign. Here is plus 4, here is 4, but plus and minus there, if no sign, that means we will multiply plus and minus, and after multiplication of plus and minus it will give you minus. So minus 4 xp. Now here it's a plus multiply by minus, this is minus 2bc. Okay, and after that plus 4cx. Okay, let me check my camera covering it or not. Yes, no issue. After that we will solve, it's the first part we have solved. We have taken, I have taken here these, this part, and now ready for the next. 2x plus p minus c to the whole square is what? 2x plus p minus c to the whole square is what? So simplify here, what is the value of c? Here c is what? Minus c. Okay, okay, so first I'm writing here, how can I write here? Okay, so see, a square, this will give you what? A b, it is what? This is the value of a, this is the value of b, and what is the value of c? C is what? Minus, it's a minus c. What is the value of a? It's a 2x. A is what? 2x. What is the value of b? B is small p. And what is the value of c? This is what? Minus c. One by one solve it. So a square, what is the value of a square? A is what? 2x. So this is 2x to the whole square plus b for p, p to the whole square. A square plus b square, actually we are applying here a plus b plus c to the whole square. Same as whatever we have done here, this activity we will again repeat it. So 2x to the whole square plus b square, p square, plus what is the value of c? C is minus c here, so it's a minus c to the whole square plus 2a. What is the value of a? It's a 2x. And what is the value of b? It's a 2ab. So b for p, 2ab plus 2bc. What is the value of b? It's a p. And what is the value of c? This is minus c. 2ab, 2bc plus 2 and c. What is the c again? Minus c. And what is the value of a? A for 2x. Is it clear? So I'm again solving. It's a 2 to the 4. 2x to the whole square is what? 4x square plus p square minus c to the whole square plus c square. 2 to the 4px minus 2bc, and it's a minus 4cx minus 4cx. You can solve, it's your work, you can solve it. Okay, whatever I have done here, okay, same as you have to solve. I have already solved it, but if you want to solve yourself, you can. So this is the value of what? 2x plus p minus c to the whole square. And what is the value of 2x minus p plus c to the whole square is here, and 2x plus p minus c to the whole square is here. Okay, now we are putting the values. One by one, I will put here the value. After this activity, we will put here the value. 2x minus p plus c to the whole square is what? What is the value of 2x minus p plus c to the whole square? This is what? 4x square plus p square plus c square, and it's a minus 4xp. It's a, this is the value of 4x square plus p square minus 4xp, okay, minus 2bc and plus 4cx. Is it clear? Now I am going to rough it, and after that we will apply the sign and minus. Minus, after minus we have to apply here the bracket. And what is the value of 2x plus p minus c to the whole square? This, the value of this 2x plus p minus c to the whole square is what? 4x square plus p square plus c square plus 4px minus 2pc minus 4cx. Okay, so this is what? 4x square plus p square plus c square minus 4xp minus 2pc plus 4cx. Oh, now after, if we remove the bracket, here is actually bracket, so we will multiply minus in each term. So minus, it's a minus 4x square minus p square minus c square minus 4px plus 2pc minus will be multiplied by the minus, it will be positive, plus 2pc and again plus 4cx. Actually here is bracket involved, and after removing the brackets, negative will, sign will be multiplied by all the terms. So now cancel out one by one. It's a plus 4x square, it is minus 4x square. It's a plus p square, here is minus p square. It's a plus c square, it is minus c square. Okay, and it's a minus 2pc, it's a plus 2pc. So what is your answer at last? It's a minus 4xp and minus 4xp. This is minus 8 minus 4xp minus 4xp. Here is xp, px is equal xp. So because of minus 8xp, and after plus 4cx plus 4cx, this is what? Plus 8cx. This is your required answer. Okay, let me check the answer. Question number 3. Minus 8xp and plus 8cx. Yes, it's correct answer.